People have been asking us to comment on the news that the next Silent Hill game will be created by Hideo Kojima and Guillermo del Toro, starring Norman Reedus as Norman Reedus.
With an S, right?
S
not Hill? Hills?
S.
So it's in plural. Plural fun, plural scariness.
Plural scariness.
We did a video podcast about a possible Kojima Silent Hill game before, but that was before it was official.
Yeah. Kojima's gonna make the next Silent Hill game. Did you know that?
Did you hear that?
That video was about people jumping on Kojima's desire to make a Silent Hill game and reporting it as confirmation that he would. There was no evidence building, only speculation. Calling it evidence would be like calling my desire to have $1 million evidence that I will soon have $1 million.
When we first saw the news, we were skeptical. We wondered whether or not the teaser's ending was faked. Kojima and Silent Hill make sense, but Guillermo del Toro and Norman Reedus? It sounds like someone's wishful thinking after seeing pictures of Kojima with the other two. On top of that, one random person's Twitch stream was the only proof of an official announcement. None of us had a PS4, so seeing it for ourselves was out of the question. We were wary to believe anything less than confirmation from Kojima or Konami via some trusted source.
And no, video game journalism sites reporting on a Twitch stream doesn't count. We know how easy it can be to create a fake trailer and fool the internet. Will it be a good game? Probably, definitely. Kojima knows what he's doing when it comes to game design. You don't need us to tell you that the Metal Gear and Zone of the Enders series are top tier. At the very least, it's guaranteed to be the best game in the franchise since Silent Hill 3, which won't be hard to pull off. This game will have excellent gameplay, graphics, and sound.
But Kojima has a tendency to write incomprehensible storylines, which could be a good or bad thing. Silent Hill 1 may be incomprehensible until you beat it a few times and fully understand what's going on. Then it makes total sense. Silent Hill Downpour, on the other hand, makes no sense and then makes even less sense once you fully understand what's going on. Complicated doesn't automatically mean good when it comes to Silent Hill.
And that's actually my biggest contribution to Homecoming, is I went in and made it confusing again, because they had a very set answer that they wanted to provide, and that's just not okay in Silent Hill.
But one thing Kojima is very competent with in his storytelling is emotion. If you didn't get even a little choked up at the end of Metal Gear Solid 4, then you are a robot, please leave. A story about a character we actually care about that's sad and depressing is just what Silent Hill needs, and we know Kojima could deliver. However, the correct supernatural and cult elements would also have to make a return, otherwise this could end up being yet another game whose only connection to Silent Hill is the title on the box.
PT tells the story of a man trapped in a house that's haunted by ghosts of a woman and her unborn baby, murdered by the baby's father along with their son and daughter. At the beginning, an unknown entity warns the man that the gap in the door leads to a separate reality and talks about what sounds like doppelgangers. The very end of the demo features the murderer's son, now grown up, speaking through a radio about the incident and about how he'll be returning with his new toys. Norman Reedus is then revealed.
The credits for the demo state that it has no relation to Silent Hills, but we don't know how much of the demo that covers. Is it talking about the entirety of the demo, or just the gameplay and graphics? If the radio message at the end is indeed part of the teaser, then other parts of the story from the demo would also carry over, and that means Silent Hills will include multiple realities, doppelgangers, and ghostly revenge. Since both the teaser and the trailer for PT feature Norman Reedus paired with text describing these things, we can't rule out the possibility. Doppelgangers? That's fine. Ghostly vengeance and multiple dimensions? That's not.
As for Norman Reedus' involvement, well, if you like Norman Reedus, then you'll probably like him in this game. And if you don't, then you won't. One thing that we're not impressed with is the quality of the horror in the demo. Kojima has done horror before, but it's always colored with his strange fourth wall breaking sense of humor, and the demo is no different. We don't feel there's any place for fourth wall breaking in Silent Hill. And before you throw the UFO or dog endings at us, remember that those are only available after the game's been completed.
Kojima's tweets and post-reveal interviews suggest that the horror and atmosphere in PT is the kind of horror Kojima is capable of, the kind he thinks is scary.
So it's a very scary game, so I mean, if you get scared easily, you know, just get together with your friends or whatever, or on Twitch with different people and just go ahead and play it.
Ah! this is what we should expect from Silent Hills, then there's going to be a problem.
But one thing that you have to keep in mind is that if a game is too scary, people just won't play it. So the one thing in movies or in attractions, you know, it's about to start playing pressing the play button or just getting in the ride, and you know, if it gets too scary, just keep your eyes shut and somehow it'll be over. But if it's a game, people will just stop, you know, and won't keep on playing. So that's why there's a limit of how scary you can make a game. But in this case, we're totally ignoring that. And you know what? If you don't want to keep playing the 3D game, so be it. We don't care. That's the game we are aiming for. We're aiming for a game that will make you shit your pants. And so, yeah.
Whether or not PT is scary is up for you to decide. But whether or not it lives up to Team Silent's work is another matter. It's not Silent Hill scary. It's Haunted House scary. We found it to be stereotypical and lacking in that Silent Hill style of, oh my god, what is this thing? I am simultaneously repulsed and fascinated by it, and I don't want it anywhere near me. The mixture of sex and death that made the original games disturbing on such an extreme level is absent in favor of jump scare, jump scare, jump scare, plasticine babies crying in the sink.
This could be where Guillermo del Toro comes in, because we're assuming he's going to be designing Silent Hills' monsters. We don't doubt his abilities as a monster designer, but in an interview he stated that he doesn't look at other people's monsters when he designs his own.
The one thing I never looked at designing monsters is other people's monsters.
Yeah.
Like when I was designing the robots on Pacific Rim, the last thing I looked at was robots.
Does this mean he won't look at Silent Hills monsters unless he's directed to do so? That would break the trend of newer developers copying the damn lying figure over and over and over, but it could also mean that he makes monsters that don't follow Silent Hill's monster design philosophy.
Something everyone needs to consider is that most of the people working on the project will be making a Silent Hill game as part of the Silent Hill franchise, and the franchise is unfortunately made up of more bad than good. They're working from the original games, but they're also working from everything that's not the original games. That means they'll be considering everything that happens in Origins, Homecoming, Shattered Memories, Downpour, Book of Memories, probably both movies, and maybe all of the comics too.
From the things he said, it doesn't seem like Silent Hills is some grand vision born of a passion he's had for the series since the very beginning. It feels like Kojima woke up one day and said, "What other franchises does Konami own? Silent Hill? That sounds easy. I think I'll do that." And then threw Reedus and Del Toro in there just because he likes them.
That's not saying being a fan of the series automatically qualifies you for the job.
I love Silent Hill. I'm obsessed with it, you know?
But it ensures you'll have a better understanding of what the series is about, especially with Konami's Silent Hill experts greenlighting the original Homecoming story before Tom changed it.
And once we did that, we actually cut it into a video, put some of Akira's music to it, and said, "We think we understand Silent Hill, and this is what we're going to do with it."
Konami does not know crap about Silent Hill, and that's probably the thing we're most worried about.